Hello and welcome to today's show. I'm your host Lily.
And I am Nicole, and this is
A Girl's World. On today's show, we will be exploring, empowering and embracing women and all their talents.
Because in 2020, anything is possible. This year has been a real eye-opener, and today we want to show off all the things our ladies can do. Because living in a man's world, we want to show why we are better. But I must admit, us ladies are full of surprises. So, Lily, do you have any surprises or tricks up your sleeve?
I might have a few. How about you? Any hidden talents?
Well, I might have a surprise in store for later on in the show if you're lucky, but I don't want to spoil it for you guys.
No way, you've got to share it with us later.
Maybe. But anyways, guys, coming up today,
we have Tom and Jazzy battling it off in the kitchen.
Jen talking about all things football, and our friend Liam is going to pop into the studio to have the ultimate test to see how well men really know us females.
Joined with us in the studio now, we have Natasha giving an exclusive of her tasty treats. But before we dive right in, it's over to Tom and Jazzy in the kitchen for their baking battle.
Hi everyone, and welcome to the baking challenge. So I'm Jazzy.
And I'm Tom.
And today I'm baking a gooey fudge brownie.
And I'm going to be making triple chocolate cookies. Okay, so for the triple chocolate cookies, you're going to need caster sugar, butter, cocoa powder, self-raising flour, one egg and two milk chocolate drops.
And for the brownies, you're going to need some plain flour, butter, granulated sugar, cocoa powder, a bit of salt, two eggs and milk chocolate chips.
Right now I'm creaming my butter and sugar together.
So I've just mixed in.
Make noise and flour grams.
Yeah.
Not too loud though. Alright,
So I've just mixed in most of my ingredient and it's looking
a bit wet.
Sorry, but why does yours look like mash?
Trust the process. Okay.
Ooh, but you can't do that. Just crack the whole egg. Ooh, did you get a shell in it?
No.
Yeah.
Take your time.
I will.
Right, so I've added most of my ingredients and it's looking a bit dry. What?
I mean, look at that! Look at mine!
Yeah, the yours is brownie.
Thank you. So these are our final products. I think I did a better job.
It's the icing sugar for me.
We don't talk about that.
Anyways, let's head back to the studio where Nicole and Lily will judge our baked goods.
Well, guys, we have the brownies with us today.
They look
great.
Amazing.
Don't they?
Yeah, they do.
Yeah.
And they smell fantastic.
Yes. Thank you so much for bringing them in. What one do you think we should try first?
Well, I think you should go for the cookie first.
Is that your favourite?
I'm not going to say. I did have a bit of a taste, but I'm not going to say.
Okay, shall we try the cookie?
Don't spoil it for us.
Let's go. Cheers.
Cheers.
How's that?
Oh, wow. That'll be hard to beat, don't you think?
It was a bit hard, yeah.
Wow.
I like that a lot.
Me too.
You know, like, when food's really good, it makes you dance.
Yes.
That's how I feel.
Let's try our brownie. Oh, wow. Okay.
I love a moist brownie. I think that's my favourite.
Jazzy made that one.
Jazzy?
Yeah.
Well done, Jazzy.
Personally, I prefer the brownie.
Yeah. The brownie
is amazing.
So, Jazzy, you are our winner today. Thank you so much.
Well done, Jazzy.
So, guys, thank you, Tom and Jazzy. I must say, they tasted as good as they looked. Much better than the ones I grabbed from the local Sainsbury's, to be honest. How about you?
Yeah, definitely. Now joined with us in the studio, Liam is in store for a fun challenge to see if he can guess the female products correctly.
Hi, Liam.
So, Liam, how are you feeling about this challenge?
I don't think I'll do too well, but I'll try my best.
Come on, a bit of enthusiasm, you can do it.
I know, I'm sure you'll do great. Feel free to play along at home and see how many items you can guess correctly.
Here's our first one.
Okay. I mean, it looks like a chocolate donut, but I think it's what goes in girls' hair when they like put it into like a bun. I don't know what it's called, but it's like a bun.
There we go. Well, it's a hair donut, isn't it? Now we have, let me see.
Okay, I think that's a eyelash curler.
Did you practice?
Maybe, just a little bit.
And what do you think this is?
From first look, I haven't got a clue, but if it's a guess, I think it's like what girls wear if they've not got like a bra on or something.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty close. That's pretty close.
To cover up certain areas.
Yeah. Oh, dear. Oh, I've got no idea what that is. I might need a little help here.
Kind of clamp it a little bit.
Is that like for your eyelashes as well, then?
Yeah, we go.
Well done, you. Okay, now we have. I'm not actually even sure which way
that goes. I don't know what way it goes
either. It looks like a funnel.
Funnel what
for
though?
Where?
Is it to like pee out?
Nearly.
Is it to pee out of? No.
I'm not sure.
It's like.
It's a moon cup.
Never heard
Menstrual
of
Menstrual cup, maybe. Yeah. For periods and stuff.
Wouldn't know.
So womanly things. You need to learn about
next
these things.
We have.
Is that like an implant?
Yes, it is indeed.
Well done.
And our final one of the day.
It looks like an oven mitt.
It does. Well, mitt, yeah. What sort of mitt, though?
Is it like a makeup thing? So, like, you brush, like, foundation or something on it?
You're so close.
Oh, no.
Fake tan.
Fake tan. Oh.
Close, though.
Close.
Well, very well.
Great
anyways.
Job, Liam. How did you guys do at home? So,
well
guys,
done.
It was great having you in today. But next, we have a local 20-year-old poet from West Midlands here performing her own poem called Big Little People.
Everybody's living in their own little bubble, trying to survive their own little struggle. A little bit of gimme this, a little bit of gimme that. They all want to say a little bit of the top's where I'm at. Everyone wants a taste of a little billionaire pie and will kick, shove and push to get a little slice. They say being rich ain't so much like heaven, it's more like being in hell. But everyone be like, I want to find that out for myself. I say, life is a big people's game. Not knowing how to win big time is a real shame. They say the age range is 30 to 49. Well, I say, hustle from 0 till 99. Because being happy and successful should last for a lifetime. They talk about being the bigger person, the bigger man. It's all about knowing who you are, your morals, knowing where you truly stand. Big people, little people, I'll tell you the difference. Big people aren't intimidated by the little people. They're resilient. They take pride. They're not weak-minded and feeble. Now, I'm not saying that we should take sides. What I am saying is there's a massive big little people divide. And at times, it's more than what just meets the eye. The root is the mind, your thoughts, which influence your words, your actions, your deeds. Now, none of that rhymes, but I just wanted you to see that your fate is decided by a little seed up here. Just think about that. How every time you have a little chat with yourself privately, your final destination is being mapped out silently by you, you who has the potential to turn little ideas into life-changing schemes. A small-scale initiative can meet someone else's needs. Now I'm looking at the confused faces of you all. It is okay to start small. But don't just be happy for it to stay that way. I mean, it's your game, be in it for the big play. Starting little is absolutely fine. It's the little person mentality that keeps you behind.
Well, thank you, Abby. That was absolutely fantastic. I loved that poem.
Thank you.
You looked like you were in your element. I loved all of the sass that you gave us.
Yeah, so that was great. I have so many questions to ask you. For instance, what inspired your writing?
Well, you know, I get inspiration from a number of different places, you know, the different experiences that we have in life. All of those contribute to what I write about.
Wow, and I have another question for you. Do you write a lot of poetry about this topic? Do you write about all different things?
All different things, this topic, anything really. Anything that I see and I think, yeah, that would sound good in a poem. So sometimes it can be entirely random.
Okay.
Obviously, you're a young poet, and how long exactly have you been writing poetry for?
Oh, years, since I was quite young. I think possibly I was probably, you know, formulating poetry even before I was able to write it down.
Well, thank you, Abby. It was wonderful hearing from you today, and I definitely want to be hearing more of your poetry in the future.
Now we have a young photographer, Lily Kiffin from Sutton Coldfield, showing off some of her photography techniques.
During lockdown, people have took to exploring new hobbies to fill their free time. One of these hobbies being photography. I've been doing photography for a while now, and I thought I'd help you guys out with a few tips and tricks on how to make your photographs a little bit more creative. Today we'll be looking at long exposure photography and have a go at creating our very own light trails. What are light trails? Light trails is pretty explanatory in its name. It's light that trails across the screen. All you need is a camera and a tripod. So let's go find a location, set up our camera, and get started on how to create your own light trails.
So here we are in central Birmingham. This is the perfect place to practice light trails, with the traffic and the busyness of the roads. Today we're doing it in daylight, just for filming purposes, to show you exactly what you need to be doing. It would be best if you do it in the night time to get the full effect of the light trails. So let's get started. The exposure triangle can help us create the perfect light trail. What is the exposure triangle? Well, the exposure triangle consists of three features: aperture, ISO, and shutter speed. Aperture is the iris of the lens. So the wider it is, which is lower the F number, the more light is let in to the lens. ISO is a sensitivity to light. So the darker the environment you're in, the more sensitivity you need. And shutter speed. Shutter speed is the speed the shutter opens and closes. So for us to get a motion blur, we need a slow shutter speed. Here's photo number one. This is the standard settings that my camera was on originally. As you can see, the photo is really dark, so we probably need to turn the aperture down a little bit, the sensitivity a little bit up, and as you can see the shutter speed is really quick, so we need to turn that down a little bit more. Here's photo number two. With this photo we can see a little bit of motion blur. So that's at 2 seconds with the shutter speed. Let's turn that way down and see what happens next. Here's photo number three. As you can see, the light trail's trailing across the screen. I'm really happy with these settings. So let's go take some more shots. And there we have it, our very own light trails. Remember guys, you can use this effect on other things as well, like water and even stars. Thank you guys for tagging along, and I'll see you next week where I show you guys how tights can be used for filters on a camera lens.
Well, thank you, Lily, for showing us how to take some light trails. We now have the photos in the studio with us to have a look.
Yeah, they look fantastic.
They do. You can kind of see, I'm presuming that this is a brake light.
Yeah, and then there'll be like the backlights of the car.
Wow.
And it even captures the lampshade as well. And I like the blue in the sky.
Mm-hmm. I wonder if we have any more. Oh, wow, I love this one. It's like a silhouette, kind of like lace kind of vibe. Do you see what I mean?
Yeah, it does look a bit like lace, doesn't it?
Wow.
Yeah.
I do really enjoy these photos. Now I want to kind of try and use the
techniques. Home,
yeah, let's see. If any of you guys give it a go, don't forget to send in your photos so that we can have a look. But we now have Jen, who has joined us over here in the studio to talk all things football. But sadly, guys, I'm going to have to leave you. Oh, yeah. I can't tell you why, but I'm about to go. See you all later.
Ooh, exciting.
Bye.
Well, I guess it's just going to be me interviewing Jen then. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. It's lovely to meet you. So, how long have you been playing football for?
I started playing when I was about 8 or 9, so about 10, 11 years, yeah.
Quite young.
Yeah.
And what do you think about the growth in women's football and the stigma surrounding it?
Oh, it's great. The growth has been amazing. When I started, I had to play on a boys' football team, and now there's just so many young girls getting into it. So they've
more
got able,
teams.
Yeah, they've got able to have the confidence to be themselves around other girls playing rather than trying to compete with the boys.
Fantastic. And how do you feel about the pay difference between men and women in professional football?
Club level, obviously, there's a massive difference, but national teams have started to pay the players the same amount, so it's getting fairer. And with the rise and the sponsorships and stuff,
and
they'll get bigger.
I think we've got some of
brought
your
a couple
pictures
of pictures
in, don't we?
Yeah.
Do you want to talk through them?
That was after a tournament when I was 10, so I just won that at my first team, and then I got another one. That was last season at uni. We won the league and lots of champagne. That's me in the number one. So played in goal, and we just won 2-1. And we won the league, and it was a great day, a great time.
It was an open day with your champagne, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, have you ever played football before?
No.
Would you ever give it a go?
I don't. I'm not into sport, really. I tried netball, like, at school and stuff.
Netball's a lot different to football.
Okay, thank you, Jen. Thanks, everyone, for watching. I hope all the ladies watching today's show enjoys themselves and those who took part in the show. And I hope you're more empowered than ever. It looks like Nicole is back in the studio. Let's see what she has in store for us today.
Stranger to the dark, hide away, they say, 'cause we don't want your broken parts. I've learned to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, they say, no one will love you as you are. But I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us.